Vision Group Chief Executive Officer Don Wanyama and Deputy Editor-in-Chief Felix Osike have today handed over the condolence book that was opened to honor Queen Elizabeth II to the British High Commissioner in Kampala. The book was received by the Ambassador of Britain to Uganda, Kate Irie, at the British Embassy head offices. The CEO explained why Vision Group decided to open up the condolence book to the public at its headquarters in Industrial Area.
Of this relationship, and so losing her obviously hit us hard as a country. And you did see the president and the first lady came and condoled, and they made that very clear. And so as a group, we thought it was important for us to be able to give a platform to our staff and our other stakeholders to be able to join in this grief and express their grief and condolences. That's why we came up with the idea of having a special condolence book set up at our head offices, where people would walk in and basically leave a message.
He hailed Britain for its contribution towards Uganda's development.
In the interest of this country, we understand the relationship between Uganda and Britain. It's very important, not just that they were protectorate of Britain, but even after independence, we've had a very important relationship in terms of supporting development and all these other things.
The British ambassador to Uganda commended Vision Group and Ugandans at large for their big heart. She reiterated the commitment by the two countries to continue working together for prosperity.
But like I say, the bit for us is just how much it's a great source of solace and comfort just to realize that a woman who meant a huge deal to the people of my country also meant a huge deal to the people of yours. And that to share, you know that to share grief makes that grief somehow lighter. And, you know, Uganda has done us a huge service in lightening our grief over the last 2 weeks, for which we are profoundly grateful.
Relatedly, Vision Group CEO Don Wanyama paid a visit to Finca Uganda offices in celebration of 30 years of existence. Report by Jaliet Namowaya for the news.